Greetings to all. This is Dr. Suchishmita Ghosh, second year PGT in the Department of Anatomy at North Bengal Medical College. Today we will be discussing the dissection in the front of forearm. We will be seeing all the important structures that are present in the front of forearm. Okay, beginning with the incision, we have a transverse incision at the junction of upper 1/3 and lower 2/3 of the forearm, leaving the space for cubital fossa above. Below the transverse incision rests upon the wrist joint and one longitudinal incision joining the midpoint of the previous two incisions. Then we have the skin flap. The two skin flaps are reflected. Along with the skin, below the skin we have the superficial fascia, which has also been reflected in the same way. Then we have the deep fascia of the forearm, which is also known as the antebrachial fascia. The antebrachial fascia in the region of the cubital fossa is reinforced by the bicipital aponeurosis, and at the level of the wrist joint, it is continuous as the flexor retinaculum. It is thickened and continuous as the flexor retinaculum. The deep fascia is also split in the same way. Then we see the muscles, nerves and vessels that are present in the anterior aspect of the forearm. The muscles are present in three groups, arranged into three groups. In the superficial group, we have five muscles that are arranged from lateral to medial. Firstly, we have the pronator teres muscle here. Then we have the flexor carpi radialis muscle. This is the flexor carpi radialis. Then we have the palmaris longus. This is the palmaris longus, the tendon of palmaris longus, that after the after crossing the level of flexor retinaculum becomes continuous as the palmar aponeurosis. Then we have the flexor carpi ulnaris, that is present most medially. After this, we have the flexor digitorum superficialis, the four tendons of flexor digitorum superficialis, which are also considered as a component of intermediate group. Then after these five superficial group of muscles, we move on to the deep group of muscles, which are again from lateral to medial, flexor pollicis longus. Below the flexor digitorum superficialis, we have the flexor digitorum profundus tendons, four tendons of flexor digitorum profundus, which are present here. Then we have here a quadrangular shaped muscle, this one, this is the pronator quadratus muscle. So these are the muscles, again in the superficial group from lateral to medial, pronator teres, then flexor carpi radialis, then palmaris longus. These are the flexor digitorum superficialis, four tendons of flexor digitorum superficialis, and most medially flexor carpi ulnaris. In the deep group, again from lateral to medial, flexor pollicis longus, then flexor digitorum profundus here, the tendons of flexor digitorum profundus, and we have this pronator quadratus muscle, which is quadrangular in shape. Next, moving on to the vessels, on the lateral aspect we have here the radial artery along with the venae comitantes. On the medial aspect we have the ulnar vessels, the ulnar artery. These are about the vessels. Then next about the nerves, on the medial aspect along with the ulnar vessel runs the ulnar nerve. This is the ulnar nerve, and we have the median nerve, which is present here. This is the median nerve. That is about the structures present in the front of forearm.